So game two then. Well, I should really have adjusted the thing on Twitch actually. Let's give me 2 minutes while I do that, and then I'll get the game loaded. So okay, that'll do. Right, so let's load up the game and hope that things actually work as they're supposed to. It appears to be. Hello, peoples!
Imagine a future where we have solved many of the problems plaguing humanity today. Food and energy are issues of the past, and human beings have established orbital and lunar colonies. We here at IDGI have invented a satellite capable of transporting you to this not-so-distant future. And the rest is up to you.
Hello and welcome to Consortium, a game which I've played a couple of times through, but I've stuck myself at the one particular moment. Because there's a mystery involved in it, and I have yet to solve it. So therefore, this is basically Star Trek, in many ways, as I see how Star Trek should be. This is not The Escapists. This is Consortium. It, basically, the point of this game is that we in the past have the inventive technology to hack a person's mind in the future. And apparently everybody in the future has forgotten this technology exists. And, yeah, so we're basically going to take over somebody's mind. We're going to play on intermediate because I have played through this a little bit, but I haven't actually done anything yet. There are multiple ways you can play through this game, as I've discovered. You basically have an alignment system with every member of the crew, and at every option you have the option of saying absolutely nothing, which in some ways might be safer. But, you know, there's other ways you can play this game as well. You can play it also like a complete bastard, shooting everybody to death, and yeah. It has detective mystery elements in it, but it's not that sort of game. As I say, you basically have hacked somebody's mind in the future and you decide what happens, really. There are events happening all around, which you may or may not be the cause of. It's kind of hinted you might be. But depending on what actions you take, determines where the story goes. And I think alignment is a big thing in this, possibly affecting the ending. As I say, I've only played up to this point with a mystery and I haven't solved it in both my previous attempts at this, so... You know, it's something I'm going to try and do. I've explored different ways of doing it and ask different questions, but we'll see. The game apparently has stopped. No, it is loading still. All right, a little worried there. This might not be the best. It is buggy as hell, though, I will be honest. I will be having to save a lot and reload. Well, no, we've hacked somebody's brain in the future. That's basically what the technology is. A lot of things can happen. A lot of things, in fact, will happen. We're now connecting to Bishop Six, who is our character in this game, effectively. Yep, come on. That would help. And through the tunnel of Wibbly to take over a person's mind. I have no idea why they added this little bit other than possible foreshadowing of events, which I haven't got to yet. One thing I should probably do at this point is just make sure. Sorry, that is important. Oh, which edition are you playing? And this is possibly Bishop. Also, one of the things I do like is that there is sort of interference, background interference from events, possibly in the past, possibly here, which affects your connection to the game, effectively. This is the inventory screen. Whenever you go into inventory, time slows to about a quarter speed, so everything sort of happens in real time, but you can slow it up slightly.
workers were found dead in a cargo container ship. The ship had initiated auto-docking procedures.
Come in.
Personnel on site reported as finding no survivors aboard.
Much better. Not so sorry to wake you, Bishop. We thought you should know about our little escort.
Arguably, no.
That's the latest from here. I'm Malcolm Thomas.
Worry? No, Bishop. There's nothing to worry about. Not unless
probably
you're afraid of a couple crummy American F-35s piloted by a group of washed-up mercenaries. A few more bad apples who wish the war never ended. It's just another day in the Consortium.
Hurrah for that! Crummy, Americans make the best stuff, do they? Don't know. You basically have a timer for every single question, but,
To escort us through Bulgaria. It's a long story, but let's just say the leader of this particular crew has a very strong disliking for our way of doing things. He likes to think he's doing the people of Bulgaria a service by...
It possibly is. I'm not sure.
Really, they're as fed up with him as the K and I are.
What is the K?
Oh, right. That's just what I call Night 15. We've been dealing with these guys for years now, and I like to think Kirill, their leader...
Also, I think the tech... I did put the tech hex chat stuff on just because it'd be easier, but...
her when you came on board, remember? She's technically our operations manager, the leader of our little team.
I never met her, but then I'm hacking somebody's brain.
We just met 2 hours ago.
I'm deliberately trying to piss her off here because I didn't do this the first time around. I've been friendly with Rook 25 most times I've played through this.
At the moment, we're about 45,000 feet over central Bulgaria. What? Are you kidding me?
No, I'm not kidding you.
Are you feeling all right? You're on a C-3800 Consortium command vessel, codenamed Zenlil.
Okay. Not sure how I want to handle this anymore. I could say nothing, but...
It means you're in a plane, Bishop. Okay? A really big arse plane.
Yay! Simplified with pictures!
So let's get you suited up and ready to kick some homeless arse. Here are your basic Consortium tools. You got your PCU, BUS and assault helmet, all specifically tailored to fit you nice and snug.
And now I have stuff! Homeless arse?
Yes. Yes, I did. The group we're up against here are unofficially called...
This, by the way, is sort of, as I said, the inventory sort of works in real time. Real time sort of works at a quarter speed. It is, we will get weapons and various other things. Oop.
I'm not surprised you've never used this equipment before.
Nope, we never have 20 years in the past.
It's so expensive. We're one of the only agencies in the world who use it. Think SSK, only with built-in hardpoint sockets.
I have absolutely no idea what you've just said.
Huh? What part don't you understand?
I'ma still be tired.
No problem. We're in this together now, till death do us part. Or at least till retirement do us part. You know what? You're acting a little lopsided.
Oh, this hasn't happened before.
Maybe you should go and see Rook 13 in the med bay. I'll tell him you may be coming. It's your choice, whether or not to go, of course, but...
I've not had this one before.
Safe, right? We don't want a banged up bishop on our hands.
Right.
Now, Horn 7 and I have some CCU maintenance to take care of in the lower crawl. Feel free to wander the ship and meet your new crew.
Yeah, it is a very dialogue focus. Hold on, let me actually just see if I can adjust some things on here.
Next to the elevator. Oh, and don't forget to go and get your CMC from the K. You can find her in mission operations at the end of the hall to your right.
Okay, so let me just see if I can quickly adjust thing here. I should be able to position it a little further. I don't remember how I did this last time. Punch her in the face! That'll piss her off. You could do. It's possibly an option. She's basically an engineer. From what I've sort of gathered, the Rooks are the engineering class, Bishops are the security officers, effectively. Pawns are the grunts, and the knight is the captain, effectively. There are others. There are other ranks as well that are involved, but they're all chess pieces, and they're all sort of semi-logical. Why are you not letting me do that? No, if anything, I've just made it slightly bigger. That hasn't actually done it a lot here. All right, what I might do then is I might turn off the closed captioning, but I do like having the closed captioning on. At least until I can work out how the heck I fixed the chat into that position. I basically worked this all out a few minutes beforehand. So basically, I've got to do my CMC training, but I'm intrigued. I've never had... Yeah, thank you. I know he's on the lower deck, so... Whoops. I punched loads of clones! And lots of whistling. I remember this. So there's pawn 11 in there. We'll leave her alone, though, because, you know what? We're decent folk like that. Pawn 44. Yeah, we'll toss you.
Well, hey, the new bishop. I got a few minutes to talk if you want. How was your sleep? Those bunks up there can be pretty comfortable. They're 60% made of hemp. Canadian hemp. The best in the world.
Can't feel the bunks. It's not my skin.
Well, what? I mean, what's that you just said? About your skin?
Yeah, she was whistling. There we go.
I'll bet it does.
Kill the whistling!
I felt the same when I made the switch from working for an airline. Like going from being a fly to an Andean condor. You just wait a couple missions, I promise. You'll start to feel right at home.
Oh, hey, Bishop. I didn't hear you come in. I have to get back to work.
He, by the way, is my prime suspect. But
are you coming to the party or not? We're having it before you leave for home, the second we're done in BC. No excuses will be accepted.
No, I can't. I'm sorry. It's nice to meet you.
Well, we've had that talk. Alright, the whistling has stopped. I think I actually tend to torture if I notice that, but I didn't do it this time. Oh well. It's fine. We'll worry about things like that later. Meantime, medical bay.
Bishop Six, welcome to the medical bay.
This place is disastrous. I do apologize.
Oh, come on, Kieran. Greet our new bishop.
I don't like Kieran, by the way.
It's nice to see you again.
He does like TV. What was that you're watching?
It's nothing. What can I do for you?
It was 2D.
Let's stay friendly with the rook.
UVI, the device I implanted behind your ear when you first boarded Zenlo. I told you this before. I can monitor all of your vitals and even help in more severe emergencies. Medical utility visual implant.
It's always with a dodgy Irish accent.
I told you this too, when I stuck it in you. It's mostly used to project your heads-up display. I can also remotely access your MUVI to help prioritize your healing nanites for maximum efficiency.
So, is there a real TV over there?
It is a 32-inch Toshiba from 1995, one of the many televisions I've managed to acquire over the years. The best in my collection is a 3-inch.
It's also the cold dead eyes.
From
the cold dead eyes.
Is actually proud of that fact?
Yeah.
Fascinating. And how did you initiate transport? Some sort of device or vehicle?
Maybe a TARDIS! That's how we managed it.
Kieran, you realize he's only kidding around, right?
Rift in time and space opened by a satellite. We'll be honest.
This rift to another dimension is thus created by your satellite, or does the satellite merely utilize something already present in space?
See, they have no concept of it, so...
Can you please change the subject now?
No, we'll keep going.
I recognize that. Good choice. And it is interesting that there are 21 of these packets. I wonder why that is.
Interdimensional games? You really remember them, Kieran? It was before my time, but they had that game, Anti-War. My father used to talk about it all the time. It was one of
So
his
maybe
favorites.
They do have... Okay, I'll... I'm confused, actually, because I didn't think this...
So the connection is made on this end. Through the king of the consortium. did not expect this turn of events.